fundamentals of leadership are the same. There are three pillars for leadership. Number one, mobilization. Number two, it's about people. Number three, it's about a good purpose, the purpose of creating a better reality for those whom you are leading. These three pillars are the same regardless of the size of the organization or the space where you're exercising leadership. However, with complexity, things become a little more difficult. So it's only logical to assume that mobilizing 10 people is different than mobilizing 100 people, is different than mobilizing 10,000 people. Of course, because every human being, every additional human being that you want to mobilize brings an entire new universe, new hopes, new fears, new insecurities, new dimensions that you need to consider so that this person is mobilized. So when complexity increases, the nature and the level of the skills that are required to exercise leadership by default increase. And people who are required to exercise leadership at that grand level, of course, are people who should be more experienced, who should, in addition of understanding the fundamentals of exercising leadership, because of the scope of the responsibility that is much greater and the price of a mistake is much heavier, the level of sophistication of the leadership itself should be more. I'll just give you a small example. If you are a pilot of a 4-passenger plane, that's a challenge. When you are piloting a 120-passenger plane, that's another challenge. When you're piloting an aircraft that, you know, carries 600 people, that's a different challenge. The level of responsibility is different. That's why it takes time for pilots to be given the responsibility of flying, you know, 600 or 700 people in these, you know, mega airplanes. At core, the fundamentals of aerodynamics, of what makes an airplane fly, the basics are the same. But of course, as you add more complexity, you need more experience, you need more wisdom, you need different levels of skills. So you have to keep this in mind. Before you embark on an adventure of exercising leadership, when you are given a new adventure or when you find yourself in that place, ask yourself if you have the necessary skills to exercise leadership in an effective and successful way. If you don't, then that's the time for learning. That's the time. That's why being humble is important. That's why having a learning mindset is important. That's why being flexible and adaptive is important. That's why being realistic is important. Because when you exercise leadership and you make mistakes, somebody has to pay for the mistakes. And often it's the people whom you're leading. So make sure that you minimize the amount of mistakes so that you protect your people whom you're trying to help. In conclusion, the basics are the same. Everybody should know them when you're exercising leadership. But the level of complexity of your skills should be proportional to the level of complexity of the context where you're operating and the task itself.